everyone, stay low. I think there's a terrifying Smilodon in here, and they're getting closer. If I'm not careful, I might find myself devoured by the terrible jaws of a saber-toothed cat. No! No! It's got me! Oh, what a world! What a world! All right, all right. I need a break from playing saber-toothed cats. Smilodon teeth really were that big. Whoa, whoa, they weren't the biggest teeth ever, Squeaks. They're pretty big, but I bet if you think a little bit, you might come up with some bigger teeth. Oh, you're right. There were some huge dinosaurs, but I'm actually thinking about animals living closer to today. Like elephants. Elephants belong to a group of animals called proboscideans. Elephants are the only members of that group alive today, but they have many extinct cousins. Extinct means they're not alive on Earth anymore. Most of these cousins had trunks and tusks just like elephants. Oh, good question, Squeaks. Tusks are actually teeth that stick out of the animal's mouth when it's closed. And tusks are some pretty big teeth. But tusks aren't the only teeth elephants and their cousins have. Some of the cousins that were around back in the Ice Age were pretty interesting looking. My favorite was the platybelodon. It had a trunk and tusks like modern elephants, but its bottom jaw stuck out like a shovel. Scientists think it may have used its strange-looking mouth to scrape food off of trees and shrubs. Yeah, it is impressive. But probably the most famous of the cousins were the mastodons and the mammoths. There were actually several different kinds of mammoths and mastodons, but they all looked a lot like big, hairy elephants. Well, at first, they do look very similar, but if we look carefully, we can see some differences. We can learn a lot about how animals behaved and where they lived by looking at their bones, especially their teeth. Let's be detectives and see what clues we can find about them. First, I notice both animals have fur. What do you think that tells us about where they lived? That's right! It was cold. Both mastodons and mammoths lived back when Earth was colder than it is today. Some parts of the Earth were still warm, but these animals tended to live in the colder areas and needed fur to keep warm. What else do you notice? Ooh, yeah, their tusks are different. Take a look at the shape or structure of their tusks. The mammoth had longer and more curved tusks, while the mastodon had stockier and straighter tusks. What do you think they used them for? Oh, right. They did defend themselves from predators with their tusks because there was stuff even more dangerous than saber-toothed cats out there, including humans. They also probably used their tusks to show off to other animals of their kind, like how peacocks strut around with their glorious tails. And mammoths may have also used their tusks to push away snow on the ground so they could get at the tasty grass underneath. Oh, right, that's a great comparison. The American bison does the same thing, and they also come from the Ice Age, but are still alive today. Bison have something else in common with mammoths. Let's find out what it is by looking at their teeth. There are three kinds of teeth an animal might have in their mouth. Each has a different job, and us humans have them too. There are incisors, the teeth in the front we use for grabbing onto food, like when we take a bite of an apple. Then there are canines, the pointy teeth on the side of the incisors. Mine are very small, but we already met saber-toothed cats with their huge canines. And then there are molars, the teeth in the back of your mouth that you use for chewing. The tusks of mammoths and mastodons are a kind of incisors, but we can learn the most about the kinds of foods they ate by looking at their molars. Let's compare the mammoth and mastodon molars. What differences do you notice? Oh yeah, the mammoth had much flatter teeth, These teeth are really good at grinding up grasses. This is because mammoths were grazers, just like bison or horses. They like big open fields of grass. The mastodon has much bumpier teeth because they were browsers. Browsers are like modern-day deer or giraffes. They eat twigs, branches, and woody material. Knowing what an animal ate can give us clues about where they lived, too. The place an animal lives that provides for what they need is called a habitat. Mammoths usually lived in wide open grasslands and tundra habitats. But browsers like mastodons are better suited for forests and wetlands. Great observation, Squeaks! In this case, looking at these animals' teeth can tell us where they lived, what their habitat was. I know, let's look at a modern-day elephant tooth and see what we can learn. These teeth are big and flat. Yeah, like a mammoth's, but they're not as flat. See the ridges? Even though their tusks are smaller and they aren't as furry, elephants are a lot more like mammoths than mastodons. We can tell they tend to graze on things like grass, but the ridges tell us they can also eat leaves and bark like a browser. We can learn so much about animals from today and the prehistoric past just by looking for clues in their bodies. They are amazing! But now that we've done that, it's time for my turn to be the ferocious Smilodon. Thanks for joining Squeaks and me today. Be sure to click subscribe so you can join us here at the fort for more fun next week.